My name is Aakash Odedra, and I'm a dancer and a choreographer. For me, Indian classical dance is a form that is connected and rooted into me, my soul, and my heritage. I was born in Birmingham, and as soon as I learned to walk, I learned to walk on my toes. So they used to say he's going to be a dancer, and every time anyone put any music on, it was just a natural instinct. You know, it's almost like someone breathing. It's just something really organic to me. My father came with a phone number one day and said, you know, here's a number. And I looked at the number at the age of 8 and I said, you know, what's this for? And he said, it's a dance teacher's number for Kathak. And I trained for 17 odd years. Kathak is a form of Indian classical dance. The spirituality attached to it brought every cell in me alive. Kathak is a form that is 2,000 plus years old. And in its traditional format, was quite specific with its bells, with its presentation. And it was performed a lot by women who are courtesans. These women were like the geishas of India. And as soon as the British came, they didn't understand the relationship of sensuality and spiritualism, and they found it very vulgar. So they condemned the dance and they said the dance should be banned. So then the art form died down. And then slowly, slowly, there were people who revived the art form. Rising was like our company baby, and it changed the course of destiny for all of us. It was a place where I went from 0 to 100 in Kathak. You know, it became very successful. So this is really the next step for us. So the bar, the production value had to go up for us all. And that's why we've got all this technology. Even though it's only me on stage, I would say I'm the cherry, but there's a whole cake behind it. And I have a really amazing team.
Can you just move around a bit, Aka, in that connect range?
The Sky Academy Art Scholarship has given us an opportunity to develop an idea and to really give it life and give it reality. The idea I wanted to explore was dyslexia. We wanted to push the idea of how we can explore imagination and how someone with dyslexia works with imagination.
We were just working late last night on a new scene which will be projected, which is an animation sequence that happens in the early part when Aakash is flicking through a book. That one's good, guys, actually. That works well. It's just showing some kind of dreamlike images that sort of pop up from his imagination as he's flicking through that book in the opening sequence.
We wanted to have this feeling of it wasn't just Aakash in the space, and it really was him sitting amongst alternate realities that are going on in his mind and bringing something 3D and tangible into the space and how best to do that.
The 3D cameras enables us to track where Aakash is standing. This generates outlines so they actually would follow him when he goes from one side to the other. I found it very fascinating to see him dance, to see him with his totally movements that I didn't see before in that way, so it's kind of fun, yeah.
We're integrating the technology into the performance. At the same time, Lewis is working with Aakash to choreograph the dance part of the performance, and you know, the whole thing's kind of trying to come together at the same time, so it's a little bit complicated from that side of things.
Turn around, you're about to come up from the round the world. 7, 8.
But technology is really unpredictable. It's meant to be paper here right now. As far as what Lewis said last time.
We've got a prototype paper thrower machine that's been fashioned out of a printer that we had lying around. And unfortunately it was damaged in transit over here, so we've had to try and fix that with the limited tools that we've brought with us.
It's going to be some more work to do.
Okay.
I can do this, but it might be tricky.
The idea I wanted to explore was dyslexia, because it's something that I personally grew up with. But what was interesting for me is to really draw people into this circle, into this confined space of the mind.
Cheers, guys. Standing by. And go.
And it was really important for objects to be in space around me, to be immersed in this murmur, as it's called. The murmur is when, you know, when a lot of starlings come together, they form this flock which flies and warps and changes. And in this warp and change, it was really interesting because in dyslexia, you know, when for me especially, when I looked at letters, they often moved or something often changed. It's about this interpretation of information which warps and changes. So I related it to the idea of the starlings flying around, and this murmur is now becoming the base of the whole subject of dyslexia. When you dance, it's really important that mind, body and soul come into align. To stay that focused and to stay that determined can become quite draining. It starts to really take a toll on your body, but I suppose it's a passion which drives you. No matter how draining it is, there's something which compels me to move. The Sky Academy Art Scholarship has been very important for me in piecing things together. So this is all possible with their support. Even though it's quite specific to dyslexia, my hopes and aspirations for MAMA is for people to be able to identify with it. So if they can take one positive thing away from that evening, it feels as if our job has been done.